Hey everyone, welcome back. So I wanted to start this series called In a Nutshell, where I discuss the pros, the cons, and also give my recommendations of each city that I visit. And since I just came back from Greece about a month ago, I wanted to start off with both Athens and Mykonos. So let's start off with the cons first. Let's just get all the bad stuff out of the way, okay? So before you get too alarmed, what I mean by sanitation concerns is actually referring to the fact that you can't actually flush your toilet paper in the toilet. So let me explain. So apparently the pipes in Athens, the sewage pipes, are very, very small. So the amount of mass that can go in them and flow through them, it's just not, it just doesn't support toilet paper for some reason. So this basically means that instead of flushing it, you have to throw it away in little trash cans that your Airbnb or maybe your hotel, depending on maybe the caliber of it, will have in that bathroom. I say that it's a sanitary concern because obviously when you're not able to throw away your toilet paper, whatever is on it, having to throw it away, I feel like just invites just more bacteria and viruses kind of in your space, and that I was just not cool with. And also it really just takes a while to get used to the idea of having to throw it away. Truthfully, my first day in Athens, I probably used the bathroom like 5 times. And I think three out of those 5 times, I probably flushed the toilet paper just cause I'm used to throwing it away in the toilet paper, in the toilet. So just be mindful that that is something you have to do. So I would suggest, you know, if you're like on your period or if you, you know, do number two, I would suggest maybe getting a extra plastic bag, or even if you have like a biodegradable bag or something like that, I would suggest maybe dumping those contents in a separate bag and not putting it in the toilet or in the trash can, because number one, obviously the smell is just gonna ruin everything. Bathrooms already don't smell that great. So I think putting it in an extra bag and maybe taking it outside or throwing it away in a dumpster if your Airbnb has that, just kind of separate it from the regular like pee toilet paper, because it's just not gonna be good. So this second con might just be like first world problems, but I'm someone who likes to take really, really hot showers. So it was a bit uncomfortable to not be able to kind of reach the amount of hot water that I prefer when taking a shower. Something that we noticed was that number one, the hot water doesn't stay for long. And number two, if you have multiple people staying with you, there's a good chance that if you're the first one showering, you're probably gonna be the only one getting the hot water. So two tips. Number one, take really short showers. Try to minimize your time in the shower to, if you can, about 5 minutes. I noticed that when I was taking a shower, that's about the range that the hot water lasted. And number two, if you have more than one person staying with you, I would suggest taking a break in between the showers. So don't take showers right after each other. Just make sure that, you know, give yourself like 10 to 15 minutes. That way the hot water can, I guess, get hotter again. So there's two things to note about the hot water. So number one, you do have to flip a switch in the Airbnbs. I'm not sure about hotels, but if you're staying in an apartment, you do have to flip a switch and you should let it stay on for probably a good 10, 15 minutes before jumping in the shower. Second, you cannot let anything else run that's powered by the circuit board while you're taking your shower, or else it's gonna overpower, the hot water is gonna shut off, and you're gonna have to pretty much do that whole process all over again. So you're gonna have to wait that extra time, probably a little bit longer, and there might even be a good chance that the hot water just may not wanna come on. So just so you don't, you know, risk having to take super cold showers for all of your trip, just give yourself a little time, wait a little bit of time to take your shower, and then wait in between showers. That way, at least everyone can have somewhat warm water. So this con isn't necessarily a con, because it is, but it's something that you find really everywhere. It's, you just have to be mindful of it, regardless of where you are, regardless of you're even a tourist. But in Athens, they have a very bad pickpocketing and scammer problem. Now, thanks to our amazing tour guide, Teo, we found out that some of the pickpockets have like MOs. So there's a few different types of people that you should stay clear of and just be mindful when you're in their presence. So one of them is actually, you may not be able to tell that they're refugees, but there is a very large population of refugees who are homeless in Athens. So a lot of times they'll like come up to you and they may have like handmade like roses, or maybe like other little trinkets that they'll just give to you, and they'll compliment you and say, oh, you're beautiful, you're gorgeous. You know, they'll ask you how your day is, and then they'll ask you for money. So in this case, they may not pickpocket you per se, but the fact that they're asking for money, they're giving you this thing and then they're asking for money, that is not necessarily a cause for alarm, because you can totally give them money, but also just be mindful that there could be someone else kind of lurking and trying to see if they could, you know, take money from you. Also, there's another group of guys who they kind of, I guess, go in groups, and they go to obviously very hot, heavy populated places, and they search out tourists, people who look like they don't belong there. And they'll walk up to you and they'll say Hakuna Matata, and they'll give you like a bracelet, and they'll literally tie it on your wrist. They'll chat with you again, just like the refugee might. They'll compliment you and ask you where you're from and all that good stuff. And then they'll ask you for donations. Now, it's totally your prerogative to give money to anyone who asks, but some of these people, just be wary of, because they're doing this all day and they're getting money and, you know, bothering people essentially. And so this is why we were told these are the types of people to stay clear from, because they're very worrisome, okay? So if you don't have the money to give, don't feel pressured to give it. If they give you something, just say no thank you and move on. Or if you want to take it and give them a donation, that's totally fine too. Also, just be mindful of people who are just really close in your vicinity, in your space. You know, obviously that's a surefire sign that someone's trying to like get all up in your stuff. So my tip to you is just keep your stuff in front of you. I suggest carrying a crossbody bag that you kind of just keep on your hip. If you have a book bag, then, you know, just really be mindful. If you can, if you don't mind, keep it in front of you. Or if you happen to have the hookup, get you a book bag that's like really secure. Maybe has some locks or things like that. There are actual like theft-proof locks and book bags and crossbody bags that you can get on Amazon. I'm actually gonna get one very soon. So definitely check those out if you're really, really nervous about the pickpocketing situation. I'm telling you guys about these particular people because me and my friends literally encountered both of these kinds of people in one day. And actually it was the day that we were taking our tour with Taya, which just made it even more funnier. Luckily for us, we didn't get pickpocketed. We did end up giving these people money. So perhaps they, you know, were just happy with what we gave them, but just be mindful that there are people who are really just searching for people to scam out of money, truthfully. All right, on to the pros. So the city is huge. There's just so much to see and do. You're not gonna be bored. I mean, truthfully, it's such a great city. And if you're a history buff or someone who likes museums or artifacts or, you know, any type of thing that has historical value or significance, you're gonna love this city. Athens is actually one of the oldest cities in the world. And it has some really amazing historical landmarks and things that you can totally appreciate. It's also a great place aesthetically. If you love taking pictures for Instagram or your website or anything like that, you're gonna love this place. Truthfully, you're gonna fall in love with it. Now, if you've been to other European cities, you probably know that it's pretty expensive to shop in Europe, or really just to do anything in Europe. However, Greece is actually, to me, the exception of the rule. Athens in particular, you can actually maneuver around Athens for a very affordable price. I mean, you could pay for a whole meal, like a burger and fries, for like €5, depending on where you go. You can get some really good portion-sized meals for very cheap. You really don't have to worry about spending too much on food. And also, like, shopping is it can be very affordable. And of course, if you go to certain markets, you can totally haggle and get things for cheaper than what they're marked. And also, if you happen to visit a shop where the owner is just, you know, super nice, or maybe he appreciates that you're from a whole different country and you're buying stuff from his shop like we actually experienced, he might just give you free gifts. We actually did get like a free little like wallet thing from one of the shop owners. So that's cool too. Just kind of show yourself friendly and just get out there, and you know, you might just get yourself some cool stuff for very, very cheap or free. So despite the pickpocketing problem in Athens, you really don't have to worry about your safety because Athens is actually very, very safe. The crime rate is probably as low as it can get. And truthfully, you can explore the city by yourself with a small group of friends or even a large group of friends and feel completely at ease. So even though Athens is a very big city, you can actually walk just about everywhere, almost everywhere. There are gonna be places where you're gonna have to either take a taxi or even take the metro. But even getting around through taxi or metro is very, very cheap, or the bus. I believe that the metro, depending on where you go, is like less than €2. I believe they do it by time frame though, so I think you have like 90 minutes between each time you have to pay for a ticket. So if you go someplace for like 30 minutes, I believe you can use the same ticket to get back to where you need to go. I might be wrong on that. I'll fact check. But yeah, you can walk just about everywhere. And lastly, the people are super accommodating and super friendly. They'll speak English to you if you don't know Greek. They'll tell you where to go. They'll tell you where to shop. They'll tell you where to eat. And if you're taking a cab, I would suggest asking the driver some of his favorite spots. He'll most likely tell you some super cool, like not really underground, but just local spots that aren't really visited by tourists that most likely have way cheaper prices. And like I said, Athens is already a very cheap place to visit. But if you just kind of be friendly and just be nice to some of the people that you encounter, the shop owners and whatnot, you could really get some amazing tidbits, tricks, tips to help you maneuver around the city a lot better and just make your time just more enjoyable. Now on to the recommendations. The Acropolis and the Panathinaikos Stadium are must-sees. You cannot possibly visit Greece without visiting Athens' most famous monuments. Tickets to both attractions are very affordable and you'll leave happy and satisfied that you came. Try to eat as much traditional Greek food as you can. Believe it or not, the Greeks can really throw down in the kitchen. And what makes it even better is that their serving sizes are really good and they use all fresh ingredients. Try to stay as centralized as you can. Staying near many markets and attractions means that you can walk everywhere and you won't have to take other modes of transportation. Load up on souvenirs made by local shop owners. They're a lot cheaper and you can even haggle your way to a cheaper price. So I hope you found this video helpful and enjoyed it. If you're curious about Mykonos, check out that video. And if you haven't seen my travel vlog of Greece, check that out too. Until the next adventure, bye. We'll be right back.